My name is Fikirini Jacobs, the chairperson of Kuso, that is Kenya University Students Organization. First of all, on my own behalf and on behalf of my brothers here, I wish to express my hearty gratitude to the comrades for making a prosaic and loving declaration by giving us an ability to have this platform to represent them at the national space. Now, our coming here today as part of the greater aim of addressing some of the pertinent issues that affect the students since the time in the world, and the more so in this 21st century. First of all, there has been an emerging trend in this country that has always been pervasive, but sure that it has always, you know, culled and hoodwinked the future of the young men and women who are in our universities as students today. And this is, first of all, the issue of expulsion and suspension in the universities. A lot of the young girls' future in the universities today have been put in the smoke screen only to be left on the mercy of the university bosses today, simply because of some simple mistakes that these students do when they are in universities, such that they are made to go out of the system for not less than 7 years for some.
This is a broad daylight contradiction. Secondly, it is in the spirit and the letter of the
master. But why is it so that the students who are expelled and suspended are made to stay home only, you know, their resumption back to school is only determined by how these university bosses wake up one morning, you know, whether they choose to reinstate them, you know, depending on which side, you know, of their body they slept on previous nights, is that that's the only determinant that can make these guys come back to the system. All we're saying is this: because we've come to realize that the number of the students who are expelled and suspended in this country is increasing day by day for very simple mistakes. All we are declaring here as the Kenya University Students Organization says, first of all, we are going to hold a very big national conference for all the students who are expelled and suspended. Thereafter, we shall organize a march to the State House and compel the president for these guys to be reinstated back to the system with immediate effect. It is on record of the Jubilee Manifesto that the youth were going to be given, you know, a priority in terms of some of these opportunities.
During this process null and void, all we're saying is students must be given a priority. We have all ways to compel them, and we are going to make sure that this thing has come to the ears and the desk of the... A lot of these perceptions and options that have been initiated in this country do a lot of hogwash works and every single thing, because these are the initiatives and the platform that we expect these guys to be using to articulate matters affecting the youth today. But why is it so that these guys are quiet even when... That means given an opportunity, we can attach ourselves somewhere and do something. But why is it so that the opportunities are not given? It's because of the nature of the system that was great. And one thing I believe is this: if the nationalism of this country will be awakened among the youth and the students, it will become the vanguard against all forms of impunity that have put this country, you know, on the dining table.
Just so heartily, when we come to the public to present our pleas,
there is nothing to smile about, and it's going to be business unusual. We are going to present this day and night. We are used to it. We are ready for every single cost. We shall march from front, and we shall make sure all the sanity is brought back. Another issue, as I finish, maybe before my brothers come in. The Minister of Education in the recent days brought up the issue of merging of universities. I think it has been a trend that is really painful to the minds of the students. I don't know how these guys interpret it. But I feel when you stand up in your own wisdom as the minister, the cabinet secretary of education, and saying that you're going to, first of all, to scrap off a course. This is a course you placed a student to go and study the university. This is a course that you placed some monies in the university account for this guy to go and study the same course. Years thereafter, when this guy is always looking, you know, is almost looking forward to graduation, then he's being told that your course, you know, is almost rendered null and void, and you're bound quickly, you know, to go back to the to square one and choose another course. I think this is so painful. It's something that we cannot take any further. We are calling upon the Minister of Education to wake up, to take a deep breath, roll on a course that is meant to change the destiny of the Ministry of Education. Because we know that education is the only thing that will put us on the equal table with those who made it and those who were born in rich families.
Why is it so that we are normally not involved when we come together, you know, to talk about some of these matters, yet we are being, you know, judged harshly and taken to be inherent bad? But the issue is, we must be involved.